Hello, my name is Henk de Graaf, and this is version number 4 of my little educational video on gray narration. If you haven't seen the previous ones, I suggest you go and see them first, but otherwise, just carry on, and we're talking about the power supply to your fans. One of the biggest mistakes people can make is to buy the fans based on the available power they get at their farm. I had an experience when somebody would have bought where someone did buy a 3.5 kilowatt fan, single phase, on a $10,000, on a 1,000-ton silo, which obviously didn't do anything at all. But that's all the power that he had available, and that's what his silo provider decided that he would then buy. Big mistake. Obviously, when you decide to buy fans, make that what it needs to be, and then find out how you're going to get the power supply. Now, there's two ways of doing that. You can actually have part of the system can be powered by the grid, and then only when you need more power will then a generator start up. Or alternatively, as a lot of farmers only do have a dual phase power that doesn't really allow them to run big three phase motors, you may want to decide to select the generator straight away, and whenever an aeration request is coming into the controller, you will then use your fan, your generator to start up first. Now, all that can be done automatically, and for that, there are a myriad of ways of actually putting that together. One of the things a lot of people forget when they're talking about grain aeration and silos, they forget how expensive this whole electrical distribution can actually become. Not only do you have your generator, as I just mentioned, but you have a switchboard that you need to build up together. And within the switchboard, there is, in most cases, some sort of a controller, and then you get your contactors and everything that comes with it. That can actually become quite expensive, so I do urge you to have a good look and see how you're going to put it all together. Secondly, we're talking about the power distribution. Now, the easiest way to imagine that, if you've got a box where all the power comes in, and from there you can control all the fans on all the different silos and run an individual cable to each and every fan, of course that can be controlled. One thing I do urge you also not to do is don't bring multiple silos into a single control. So unless you 100% guarantee that you will always have the same amount of grain at the same harvested condition and as the same percentage of fill on your silo, really don't do that. Go individual control on the individual silos. So for then you might end up with a lot of cables coming out of the central control panel. There is, however, a newer method available, and we can talk about that a little bit later when you feel that this is something for you, is have a single cable run past all your fans. In parallel with that, run a control cable so that each and every fan can be controlled via that one cable. It's a much cheaper way of doing it, and one that I really would urge you to consider if you're building a new silo setup. Thank you.